Let us suppose you approach the Empire with a peaceful resolution. The late Emperor Grammys would have lent you his ear, that much is certain, but we are dealing with Vaan Solidor. Should the princess return, he would claim her an impostor, or to tempt the resistance into battle. Vaan wants this war, that much is certain. As our ill luck would have it, the man is a military genius.
The dreams have told me thus. To reveal yourself would imperil us all. I see war, and Vane's name writ bold on history's page.
Arcadia's banners fly high. They are making ready for the coming war. According to our latest reports, the Western Armada prepares for war, under Vane's command, no less. The newly formed 12th Fleet has already been deployed. Oh yes, the Imperial First Fleet stands ready. They'll be underway as soon as the Odin's refit is complete, and there is more. The second Caravan Expeditionary Force is being called in to replace the missing 8th, so there will be no gaps. The largest force ever seen!
And then, the Nethersite is the coup de grace. Grand Kiltius, your grace. I spoke to you of my succession. Let us put that aside. Should I become Queen of Dalmasca now, powerless as I am, I can protect nothing. With a greater power at my disposal, perhaps then...
It is the Nethersite of which you dream?
I require something far greater.
To wield power against power. Truly the words of a Hume child.
I am descended from the Dynast King himself.
Indeed. Then you have but one choice. Seek you the other power Wraithwall left.
Does such a thing exist?
Journey across the Paramana Rift to the still shrine of Miriam. There rests the gift he entrusted to the Grand Kiltius of his time. Seek it out. The Sword of Kings can cut through Nethersite. Why he would entrust the power to destroy Nethersite, the instrument of his greatness, to another and not to his own progeny, I cannot say.
I think I've got the Sword of Kings already.
Hashelia Benargan, and take up your sword, or your dream will remain but a dream. Dream too fades into day.
Lassa leaves the party, so Lassa's gone now. Oh, we did well with Lassa while we had him. We did quite a effective use out of him. Hello, by the way. We started a new episode, didn't we? Yeah, so what we're doing now then, we're going to... We can get the Sword of the Kings from the Still Shrine of Miriam. I'm sure I've got the Sword of Kings already. Yeah, look, there it is. I've got it. Sword of Kings. You get it in trial mode. It's not difficult. I've got it already. God knows. So where is the Shrine of Miriam then? Is it in this area? I didn't say you've got to go down the rift, haven't you, I suppose? There's little dents in the ground everywhere. Confusing me. Right, we've got some good stuff now then. I really want to get to the Gambit shop. I might just fast travel back over to Rabanasta quickly and have a look at that. Have a look at the Gambit shop, because there's a couple that I want to get. Ooh. Kid in the way. And what I want to get is one for Bleed. That's what I want to get. Where you can do I want to do, if opponent has more than 95% health, something like that, then cast Bleed. It's probably a good way of doing it, I think. Or do I just go for it? I don't know. No, let's be clever about it. Let's go across and get that, because I think it's going to be worth it. Where are we now? Mount of Mustache. Okay, we know where to go back to then, okay. To Revenaster. Let's go back up to Revenaster and do that then. Just, it's worth doing it now. I wonder if there's anything else on the board for us to hunt as well. We sort of got to a point in the hunt where I think we hit the level. We have leveled up a few times now, haven't we? Let's have a quick look at the clan primal, what we got left. So all those are complete. We've got the Tingling Toast. So that is down in the Zeratan Caverns, which we're not going to do until we go and do the Zeratan Caverns, which is about level 40-ish. Crime and Punishment. That's another moose thing, isn't it? Down in the... Can't remember what way. In the same place we killed the last one as well. But it's a bit more difficult. So we'll like that for a little bit now as well, I think. And the Gill Snapper, which I think was a roughly level 40 you need to be to do the Gill Snapper one. So again, we'll hold off on that one for now then as well. So basically, I just need to go to the shop. The whatchamacallit shop. What is it called? The Gambit shop. Go into the Gambit shop. And we'll also head over to the sand scene, see if there's anything on the board, just in case. There might have been some stuff added that we can do now because we've opened new parts of the map. It's worth a gander, you never know. Get some cool stuff. And we'll also go over to Clan Centurio and have a look at the same thing. We have killed a few bosses, so the Clan Centurio should give us some good stuff now as well. Of course, you get rewards for killing bosses over there, which is nice. I don't think I ever knew about the Clan Centurio last time. Like, I just completely ignored it. I'm sure I did. And, yeah, I realised you get loads of extra hunts over there. We will do all the hunts on this game. We won't just... We'll do all this storyline. We'll do all the hunts. We'll do all of the Espers as well. Yeah, there's two more available. Ixtab, who is in the land of the Gareth. Okay. I'll take that. Okay, that's in the land of the Gareth then, yeah. And there's also Feral Retriever. It's in Burt Omistas, which is close, I'm assuming, to Mount Omistas. We found the following location. Yeah, in Mount Burt Omistas, okay. So those are all accepted now, okay. So there actually was a couple of hunts available. I don't know if we're too low level yet. I think we are a bit low level, really. If we can't do the Gill Snapper on that yet, I think we probably need to do a little bit more. But then again, for the level we are at the moment, maybe we are a little bit ahead of ourselves. Because the actual storyline aspect of where we were going was a bit easy, wasn't it? But the hunts we got a bit stuck on. It's the Gambit Shop? Yep, Gambit Shop, okay. So I want to do if the opponent has more than 90% health and cast Bleed. And target or foe. Not HP, there we go. Equal or lower than 90, 70, 50, 30, 10. So that is... Oh, I hate these. There we go. With 70% or more HP, that is with less than 90. These are a bit useless without me anyway. Less than 50, less than 30. This is good if you're using that poach move, isn't it? Which we could probably use with... We could do with using, couldn't we? Do we have poach? Let's go to the magic shop around here then, see if that's got anything new as well. Which I don't think we've got enough money for anyway, to be honest. I think we just spent it all. We'll come back into the magic shop in a minute, because we need to go across first to Clan Centurio, don't we? Which we can get to by going across this bridge. Speed at the run. Yeah. That's how you run across a bridge. Right, so we should get some stuff here anyway, which is good. We'll get some items. No, we haven't been to see the vendor recently, have we? There's a vendor, isn't there, that that gives you stuff. How fares the hunt, Kupo? You're a war justice already? You've been burning the midnight oil. Clan Centurio knows how to treat its hard-working members. Here's a reward for your accomplishments. 2 X potions, 2 teleport stones. Keep up the splendid work. He defeated the Elder Worm. Impressive. The Vieira Wood Wards send you their compliments. In thanks for stilling the anger of the woods. 800 gil. He defeated Tiamat. Impressive, Kupo. The Hen Miners Guild have sent you this as their compliments. Give it in notice of the labours undertaken to lessen the dangers that our daily face. 900 gil. And again, another couple of hunts that are available. Trickster in Mount Bert Omistas. Okay, so this would definitely open a lot up by going to where we've gone, haven't we? Alright. Okay, that's there. Gurdy. You're not the only one with his sights on Trickster, boy. If I make it to the petitioner before you, don't let it get you down, eh? How fares the hunt? Antillion. Oh my god, he's scary looking. And Bujerba. I had a row with my children. They got upset and ran into the Lushu mines, but they didn't realise the danger they're in. Please help. Okay, remember, I'm just an intermediary. Yes, fine. And that is in Bujerba. Okay. So no one in the Lushu mines. We've got some more hunts on the go then, which is useful. I don't know how good we are at this point in time level-wise. Probably want to do a bit more of the story first. Maybe go and do the Shrine of Miriam. Get this Sword of the Kings, which we've already got in our inventory anyway. It's a bit of a cockery, that, isn't it, by the game? So I want to come down here as well and see the vendor, because one thing I've never looked at as well is the vendor that deals with the people that work for the Clan Centurio. Now, he's supposed to get good stuff depending on how many hunts you've done. So we'll give him a go, see what he has got. I'm assuming that's the only vendor that's on the map up here, isn't it? Is it you? Nope. It's you, isn't it? By the way, Rabanastan. Clan Provisioner. Do you have anything good we can buy then? Steel Polyons. Safely move past traps. Okay, and Gauntlets. That's a bit useless, isn't it? Oh, you can sell your ethers. Okay. Drain, Oil, and Decay as well. Okay. Oil's good. Increases fire damage dealt to all foes in range. That could be really good, because if I use that and with Bash in the team, or with Balfour in the team, sorry, if he does oil, and then Fran has the fiery arrows, that's going to do extra damage. Decoy. I want decoy straight away. Yes. So decoy allows one ally to be the target of all foes, so that we can basically start using a tank, which would be pretty good then. We'll take oil as well, and drain. Transfer HP from one foe to the caster. That's interesting. I like that. Problem is, I can't afford it at this point in time. I'm going to have one diamond armlet sold. I don't need two of them, do I? I probably don't need all that either, really, do I? So let's buy a drain. Let's also get some ethers. We'll get 10. No, we'll get 20. We're going to afford 20. We'll buy 20. Right, that's good. That's good. We've got some cool stuff now then. So if I do Gambit Balthea, if I do cast, I'm assuming you're going to have this by now. All right, let's go to here. Decoy. Cast decoy on party leader. Party leader, there we go. And that is going to be your, not your main. Yeah, we'll do it as your main. First thing to do. Sweet. Then also, Pinello, you've got a lot of stuff on already, haven't you? Ash, if you can do it as well. Do you have access to that spell? Do you have access to that? No, you don't. Oh, you know, yeah, you've got Drain. See, Drain's a pretty good spell, isn't it? It's more the sort of thing Fran that probably can do it, can't she? Fran, can you do? Fran's got loads, isn't she? She hasn't got Decoy. I think she probably can get it, though, can't she? Licenses. Fran, Green Magic is what I need. Green Magic is what I need. You don't need a lot of magic, do you? Arcane. Time. White. I thought you get a lot more magic being a red battle mage, but you don't get a lot, do you? It's literally just this little chunk here. That's a little bit annoying. I was hoping to get that. Okay. Well, it starts to give Balfour a real use now, doesn't it, then? Let's go into Balfour. Let's see if I can get him some more green magic while we're here, because that's going to be his main... Because it's doing all this magic, isn't it? Right. Okay, so the next one I can get, then, is this one, which is Time Magic. Also got Time Magic 8. Time Magic 9. Okay. That's good, then, for him. Any other gambits we can give Balfour? Okay, now we can do this one properly, then. We can change this to HP 90% and above. So we'll do this here. Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that. We don't need this one, do we, actually? Okay, so let's go to... We don't need to do this either, do we? We need to go to green magic. What green magic can you do? You can do oil. Okay. So maybe... Yeah, that'll work pretty well, actually. So if... Right. So if more than... three targets... Yeah, if more than three pros present... cast oil. Is that going to work? Yeah. Because that'll work well then, because with... so I've got disable as well, though. That'll work really well, though, because that'll mean that when Ashe and Fran do the Fearer, it's going to do even more damage. And then we'll get rid of this. We'll change this to... if... What other green magic can we do? What other good stuff we got? We've got gravity. What does gravity do? Reduce HP in range by a quarter of the max HP. It's a pretty good spell, that one. Slow one action, one foe's action. Slow is an interesting one, actually. Or stop is probably the better one, obviously, isn't it? But turn one foe into stone after a short time, or berserk. Cause one ally to minus the attack or weapon in hand. I feel like we're going to go for slow. And that'll be on someone who has got more... we'll do it on... things. I don't want him to keep doing it, and that's what he's going to end up doing, isn't he? So if I say more than 90% health again... Right, so bleed... Right, so we'll do the bleed. Steel is an important one. So we'll do... do oil first, then steel, then bleed, then slow. Things he's not going to do slow because he's always going to do bleed because it's higher in the chain. Maybe do slow that way. Yeah, okay. And of course healing is more important than anything. But not 70%, let's do 50%. Okay. Right. I think we're set up now, we're set up, right. So let's go back to the teleport stone. Can I go out this way? I can go out this way. I don't often come down here, so I don't really know my way around, to be honest. Decoy is a really good spell to get, though. Which means I have to make sure that both Vaan and Barsh are only my other team, my two guys I have in charge. Because that'll mean that if I end up running around with somebody else, then it means that they're going to get the brunt of all the attacks when they probably shouldn't do. But having that, because it means that at the moment, obviously, I've got like Pinello set up to do Shell and Protect on the team leader. Balfour's now going to cast the Decoy on the team leader as well. And then if I also do... Pinello to cast Regen, I'm going to need more Gambit slots. That's what it is. Problem is, I need to probably do this off camera because I spend so much time sorting these Gambits out. But I need to get some more Gambit slots to really get the people doing what I want them to do, don't I, really? Right, so nice little detour there to Rabanasta. Let's head back over to Mount Omastas. and we'll head back then to where we're going to be going to, the Shrine of Miriam. Now, the Shrine of Miriam is where we do... Yeah. The Shrine of Miriam is where we do the boss battle, I think. I feel like I should save. I was going to go without saving. I thought, you know what, I'm just going to have to, aren't I, because of the danger of the world out there and what we've all just done. We brought some stuff. We set up some new gambits. We've been back and forth. It'd be stupid not to save the game and end up getting lost, wouldn't it, really? Right, saving the game. Saving complete. And we're good to go. Right, so back out the back of the village. And hopefully this will show us roughly where we're going to go, because I don't honestly know at the moment. I think we're going to have to go over the rift, I'm assuming, but I don't honestly know. And we don't really need to have both Fran and Ashe in the team at the same time. It's a little bit of a waste, to be fair. Look like team-wise. Okay, so yeah, we probably want to get these guys up to a 30. It doesn't really matter who we have then, does it really? So let's take out let's not do any Balfi. Let's do Pinello. Let's bring in Pinello for a minute. So I think Pinello, Vaan, and Balfi would be a pretty strong team because of casting the spells and so forth. Now I'm going to assume just heading straight down here is going to be the right way to go. I don't know if it is, but that's what I'm assuming. A Rime Fang, that's the deal frost damage to everything in close proximity, isn't it? Yeah, I'm going to assume this is the way down. Oh, we've got some stuff cropping up at the side here, have we?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow. Yeah, so Balfir now is starting to be a pretty good support guy, and that's a good use for Balfir. I think Balfir is going to be support. Fran's an all-rounder. Ashe is your black mage. Pinello is your healer. And Bash and Vaan are damage dealers / tanks. That's the basis that my mind's working off anyway now. Is that the right way to go down here by the looks of it? I don't know. There's no marking on the map to tell us which way to go, but I just assume it's this way, because this is where we haven't been. I ran straight into that. I was drinking cider and I ran straight into it. How stupid. So not having Larsa is a good thing and a bad thing. It means we're doing less damage, but at the same time, it means we get more XP out of it. We're now getting like nearly 300 XP for killing these. And there we go, Fran up to level 30. So there's that way, or there's this way. Let's go this way first. In the snow. Nice one, Fran. What have I just been done here? Oh, it cast them on me, but it didn't do anything. Okay. Alright, so we've got a chest over here we want. What's another one of those elementals? I don't like those. 32 gil. Right. Take the bad boy frog out. He's down. Got some horn from him as well. He gave us the horn. 1 gil, that was worth it, wasn't it? Where are we going to then here? Where are we going? Yeah, I'm going to avoid the elemental because they generally destroy us. They're quite strong. Let's get this chest. Remedy, nice. There's another chest up there as well. Some skeletons and another wolf. So much loot up here, it's good. A lot of XP as well we're getting. Are we being attacked by the ice? Oh, we're fighting the ice elemental. Why are we fighting the ice elemental? I don't want to fight the ice elemental, they're too bloody strong. 14,000 health it's got. We're going to have to... Let's give it a try. It's immune to physical attacks. Okay. Flee. Okay, I pressed the wrong button there. I meant to press flee and I ended up pressing fast forward instead. Oh, well, we got away from it at least anyway. We missed out on the chest though. Come on, let me have this chest. power rod. The bloody hell's a power rod. Oh, that was the wrong button, wasn't it? What's the bloody hell's a power rod? Well, let's take out Fran. Let's bring in Ashe again. He's there, yeah. Can we go across there? No, we can't. Well, let's steal all these little buggers again, then. Wild onions, you know. Can we steal from the wild onion? Yes, we can. Let's get some more succulent fruit. Come on, people. You can steal from him. Evidently not. Steal from that one. Yep, steal from that one. And steal from that one. Yeah, we can steal from him. Are you going to give another go? Didn't get anything. Oh, we got some succulent fruit from that. Okay. Stay away, people. I'm going around on my own. Don't trigger the... Oh, it's a rejuvenation trap. Okay. That was lucky, wasn't it? Oh, Murasame. That, I'm pretty sure, is possibly the weapon that Ashe has currently got. It is. It's the weapon that Ashe is currently using. That's annoying. It'd be nice if the loot you could get was one level ahead of what you're currently getting, because I've literally just brought that sword, and we've just come to the next area, and it's here. A bit frustrating, you know. Quality pelt. Ah! I was confused. I started attacking Ashe. Alright, take these two down. Are we heading in the right direction? That's the question, because I don't honestly know. I honestly have no idea where I'm going. I'm literally just wandering around. Let's steal off this big crocodile thing. Yeah, you can steal from that. Come on. Stop being a wuss. There we go. Wind Magicite. Bit useless, but still something we can sell nonetheless. 520 XP, nice. Got some fine wool and a high potion. Now, there was a chest at the bottom of here, wasn't there? I remember seeing it. There it is, good. Death. You obtained death. That's magic, isn't it, death? Inventory. Abilities? I'm sure death is a magic. Yeah. Death. Reduce one's HP to zero. Okay. That looks very effective, must say. Pinello has been silenced. Right, we need to equip Pinello with a Rose Corsage and leave it on her. There we go. That means she can't be silenced anymore then. So, Penelope, for you to use an Echo Herbs on yourself, please. Unsilence yourself, then you should never be able to be silenced again. Right. Let's push forward this way, then. Ah, skeletons. So, a bit of fear by Ashe, and it's enough to do damage to seriously two of them. Boom, took them down. Okay, so come to an area where there's two ways we can go. An ice shield. Okay, we're getting some decent stuff here. Is it better than a diamond shield? No. But you take half damage to ice, which could be useful in certain fights. Alright, so we've got this way. And we've got this way. I seriously don't know which way. Well, this top one obviously is going to join up to where the other one goes. Let's go for the top one first, then, so we just join up our map a little bit. So we know what we're doing, then, for the future. Right, what we got here, then? So I just basically just want to fill in the blanks. If I can. I want to steal some more stuff. We need the loot, we need the gil. Because when new weapons that come out, we're going to need more. We need more gil every time. Yeah, Ashe has leveled up. Nice. Let's do the bottom bit first. Because this bit looks like a dead end down here. 213 gil. See, should I be using the diamond armlet now? Because I don't know if it's good or not. It seems to be odd for me because it seems to... Sometimes you get good stuff, sometimes you just end up with loads of crap. I'm going to have to do a bit of a Google search, honestly, if it's worth it or not. Sturdy bone. Oh, we got a burgonet. How's a burgonet? Oh, I've got a red trigger trap. Aether. And another chest up here. It's got another rhyme fang in it. Yeah, so if I follow this up here, this should join up to the other part of the map then. That we had earlier. Oh, there's some stuff up here. A couple of skeletons and a slaven. There's a billich up here. Capricorn gem. Nice. Let's just kill this thing before it gets any ideas and attacks us instead. 10 gil from a good old slaven. Nice. Nice one, Pinello. The XP is rolling in now. So get this. Treasure. Demon's Bane, which is a sword, which is past. We're past that level now. Okay, so we completed this part of the map. We know where this is now. Another chest to be able to open that. Oh, wait. We're at the time of the end of episode, I think. We're finding a lot of decent loot, though. 51 gil. Right, so that's that there as well, okay. So we're going to head back down to where we came from. Which was down here. And round this way. You know, we're going to end the episode here anyway. Of course, if you have enjoyed it, please do like and subscribe as always. And I'll see you again in a couple of days' time. Oh, a tan giant skin. See you in a couple of days' time for some more Final Fantasy XII, where we will continue, hopefully, towards the Steel Shrine of Miriam to collect the Sword of Kings, which is currently in our inventory already. So I don't know what's up with that one, but there you go. Bye. Bye.